Hi all, this is Mathuravel Renayudu and I am going to teach you mathematical methods course in this semester. And here this is a course introductory video, right? So here I'd like to just explain what are all the things you are going to study and you're going to learn in this course. Okay, so here majorly we have I can say three topics. So one is linear algebra. And other one is integral and vector calculus. And other one is numerical methods. Right. So in this linear algebra, you are going to learn more about matrices. See, so far you have seen just what is a matrix. And how to add matrix and how to multiply matrix and just finding determinant of a square matrix. These are all the things you might have learned so far, right? But now in this course you are going to see what is the meaning of a matrix, what is the geometrical meaning of a matrix, like what really a matrix represents, right? And so we are going to see a matrix as a transformation. See, for example, you'd like to make an animation, a picture, right? So in which you just make a skeleton and you want to move that from one place to another place. So how do you move it? You can't simply ask it to move because it's not a human being. Just you, that's an object, you keep it in your computer, right? So unless you give some instructions to it, not like oral instructions, you should give instructions to the program language, right? So then it is going to move. Or simply, you need to define a mapping, like to move the element from here to there. So that you can see in terms of matrices. Okay. And you can see the applications of matrices in cryptography. And there are many fields when you study about electromagnetism, right? And of course, you'll come across with some differential equations. Even while solving for differential equations, you're going to use matrices. Okay. So here, so far you have seen a differential equation with a single variable and just single variable differential equations you have seen, right? But there are partial differential equations in which many of the real problems will end up with a matrix. I mean, at the end you need to understand that matrix and you have to solve that matrix. So that is where the things are there, like to solve a matrix. So for this, you need to know more about matrices. Okay, so that's what you are going to see in this course. We'll see what are transformations and how these transformations can be written in terms of matrix. And there is an important topic called eigenvalues and eigenvectors. Even after completion of your engineering, suppose if one want to ask questions on your mathematics background, one definitely ask about eigenvalues and eigenvectors. It's not that just everybody remembers it, and it is very, very important topic because you're going to see this in the application part. Okay, so here you're going to learn more about matrices. Okay, and then after it, yeah, there are many things we are going to visualize here. So I hope you're going to enjoy this topic, linear algebra, while we have this course. Okay. So, and thereafter, we'll come to integral and vector calculus. Yeah, you might say that, sir, we have already studied integrals. Yes, you have studied, but single variable integrals we have studied. But here, we are going to see two variable integrals, like integrating over a region, integrating over a space, that you are going to see here. But you may ask, why to know all those things? Why to study these double integrals? Why to study integration over a plane or a space? Yes, but when you come to the real problems, you're going to end up with a double integral kind of thing only. See, for example, I'll give you a simple example. Here, I'd like to measure the water in a pond. And I know what is the lower surface of the pond. It was given by a function. I constructed the surface, like low bottom surface, in such a way that which will follow some function property. Okay, that surface I can see that as a function. So now since you know this function, you know at what height you have the water, you just need to integrate, right? Just need to integrate to know the volume, okay? So that is where, I mean, you can see, take that as a one application of double integral. Yeah, we are going to see many, many applications of double integrals, like finding volumes, finding surface areas, right? So, finding center of moment, right? I mean, center of mass, moment. These are all the things we are going to see here in this course. And in the vector calculus part, yeah, we are going to study about the vector fields. See, let's say you're studying about fluid dynamics or fluid flows, right? There definitely you should have some knowledge of this vector calculus. It is not the basic vector calculus you're going to study. Okay, maybe in PUC you might have seen the basic vector calculus, but here you're going to move for the little advanced, right? So you're going to see the operators here, divergence, curl, right? And the most important thing is you're going to see the directional derivative. See, for example, you are on a hill and you have the map of the hill. So here you would like to move in one particular direction along that hill. But here, I'd like to know what is the rate of change in that particular direction. Like, is that changing very faster? Like, it means if it is changing very faster, it's not good to follow the direction, right? So now you better follow a direction in which you have little low slope, right? So on that surface, I can walk very comfortably, okay? So for this, I need to have an idea about how the slope is there in one particular direction, okay? So that can be known by direction derivatives. If you have that hill as a function, if you know the function, right? So then you can simply find the direction derivative and you can calculate it. And the next part, and you are going to see the most important theorems here. Those are what? Stokes, Gauss, and Green's theorems. Okay, so here, when a fluid is flowing through a surface, let's assume that you keep some object in an electromagnetic field, and there you'd like to calculate the flux across the surface, right? And that is where you can take help of divergence theorem. Okay, you're going to know what is divergence theorem while doing this course, and I hope you're going to enjoy a lot here in the vector calculus part as well. And the next part, the numerical methods. So here, you know, I'll say that this is very, very close to our real life. You know, of course, these are also very close to our real life, but this one you're going to take it more. Of course, whatever the problems you're going to see here, and if you cannot do them directly, then you're going to take help of this guy, right? This guy will help you a lot, numerical methods. Let me tell you why these numerical methods and how these numerical methods are developed. See, you have a quadratic equation, you know how to find its solution. I mean, root of that quadratic equation. You can directly find it, right? By using a formula, minus b plus r minus square root of b square minus 4ac by 2a. But here, let's assume that you are given with a fourth degree equation. Or let's assume that you are not given with a polynomial. You have given with a transcendental function. Now, how do you find root of that equation? Is that so easy? For example, if you have x minus sine x equal to 0, right? Then how do you find its root? Maybe this problem is easy. You can simply say that x equal to 0 is a solution for this. Okay, let me make it a little bit complicated. Okay, so here I'm going to take x square minus sine x equal to 0. Yeah, still you may say that, sir, I can tell you that x equal to 0 is a solution for this. But here, how many solutions can you have? Right? So if you see this graphically, I can see this as a function y equal to x square and y equal to sine x. So graphically, you can see that y equal to x square, this is the graph. And the sine x graph is nothing but, this is how it is given, right? Now you can see this is one solution and this is the another solution. Now my interest is to find what is this solution. Can you do that directly? Can you solve for x directly here? Right? No. Maybe using this graph, you can approximately tell what is that point. But I want a better approximation. So there you are going to take help of these numerical methods. Okay. And we are going to use these numerical methods to solve transcendental equations. Okay, and there are few basic and important methods. Those methods we are going to see, and then after we are going to see interpolation here. Like, given some data, I'd like to find a function which agrees with my data. Okay, so if you give me a function generating data, you can directly do that. But if some data is given and you'd like to have a function which agrees with that data, that is a difficult task. Now, how to do that? That we are going to see it very easily in this topic, numerical methods, and that is what interpolation. Okay, and thereafter we'll move to numerical integration. Yeah, I told you that you'd like to estimate the volume in a pond, right? Volume of the water in a pond. Here, if you know the bottom surface, it is easy to estimate. But I don't have any idea about bottom surface. Then what I'll do? I'll just go into the field and I'm going to get some information. Some information, I mean, let's assume you have a pond like this, right? And you're going to take the depth of the each location. Okay, so I'm going to generate some data here. So from this data, I'd like to see what is that function which agrees with my data. So then I'll find that function using interpolation only. And then once if you get that function, you can estimate, you can integrate, and you can find the volume. Okay, fine. Still, you don't like to use that interpolation. Then do one thing. So there are methods, numerical methods like trapezoidal, Simpson's, and Simpson's 3/8. Okay, and these are the methods you have. And using these methods, we are going to approximate the solution here. Yeah, and at the end, we know how to solve a differential equation. But can you solve every differential equation? Let's take first order differential equation itself. Suppose if you take dy by dx is equal to sine of x square. Do you know what is its solution? No, right? So whatever methods we have learned in the first semester, which is not useful here because we do not know what is the integration of sine of x square, right? So now that method is not useful here. Now since you cannot find solution exactly, now the question is, can you approximate? Yeah, now let us go for the approximation. So we are going to find the approximate solution here, right? So these are all the things we are going to see in this course. One is linear algebra, integral and vector calculus, and then numerical methods. Okay, so in the first two units, we are going to study this. And in the next two units, this is the part. And in the last two units, we are going to see numerical methods. Okay, I hope you are going to enjoy a lot in this course. Okay, all that you need is you just do the problems, like today problems, you just do it today itself. Okay, don't postpone it. If you follow the lectures every day, then you're going to enjoy this course. Okay, fine. So we're going to meet in class. Bye.